This is my 2017 Viking 6 Special Edition. Special Edition came with aluminum rims, factory over fenders, cloth roof, and the mud flaps. Oh, let's start with the front of the machine. I believe this bumper is a moose. It just straps right onto the factory bumper. A couple of brackets there, a couple of brackets down here. Very easy install, just wraps around the front end. Keeps the brush and stuff out of your machine. Have the front hitch here, and I got a receiver skid plate sticking out of it so it doesn't scoop stuff out of the dirt. Works nice to strap down your machine on the trailer, recovery, you know, any other attachments you want to put on the front. Got a super winch hiding in here. I just put radiator mud guards in. I have a separate video for making and installing them. I put Fox shocks on just earlier this year. They're working nicely. Sun F tires, 27 inch on the factory rims. Got mirrors, I don't remember what brand they are. Bought them off of Amazon, they're just some cheapos. They seem to be holding up, taking a beating. These are straps made for a Jeep. Also got them off Amazon. Just nylon straps, Velcroed around the roll bar. I have a truck toolbox. I believe it's for like an S10 pickup or something like that. Yep. Believe this is a Yamaha rear bumper. The Yamaha mud flaps. The spare tire holder is custom built. Made it out of a drop receiver, if you can see there. Welded a tube on the back. I couldn't find a tire holder that had a recovery point on it because, well, I get stuck in the mud and I don't want to have to take the spare tire off to get out. So I got my strap connected there. Comes up just bungeed up top here. So get buried in the mud. I can pull this out without having to get out a shovel. I have the Yamaha half windshield on here. I really like the windshield. It made a huge difference. You know, that little stubby windshield sends the air up to about here. So it goes right over your head. It does make the roof flutter in the wind a little bit at, you know, 45, 50 mile an hour. Trailering, I found that we have to move the windshield because the top really shakes on the trailer. So this has quick connects. So on a hot summer day, you can just take the windshield off. One on each side. Pretty simple, you know. Then you got the full breeze in your face. When I trailer the Viking down the road, I move the half windshield up to the top here. And I go 75 down the interstate and the roof holds up just fine. Yeah, it may be my tow vehicle and might work on all of them, but if you haven't tried it, you know, it works for me. So I got the windshield back down into its position. Just got a latch here. There's a little tab there, little tab there to keep it in place. Pretty simple. I would definitely buy the half windshield again. So the Viking 6 is a long machine. you know, from the factory, I had issues with bottoming out and getting hung up on things. I put in 2-inch lift kit. It basically moved the shock from here to here. And you know, it's a super ATV 2-inch lift. And I went to the 27-inch Sun F tires. That little bit of ground clearance I gained from the 2 inches there and the extra inch from the tires was massive. I hardly get hung up unless it's something really big. You know, I can go down the trails and don't have issues. With the 27-inch tires and the lift, I have no rubbing. There's plenty of clearance in here. Full turn, I have not touched the wire or the tire to the anything ever with it. I've heard above 28-inch tire that you can have problems. Then we got Fox shocks. Nice aluminum shocks. They were probably the most expensive thing I put on here, but they're nice. Yeah, they're not gonna give you more suspension travel or any crazy, but I went from, you know, barely keeping up to an old Honda on the trail to keeping up to a Sportsman 850 four-wheeler, which moves pretty quick on the trail. And you know, I like to ride fast, ride bumpy, and yeah, they're not miracle workers, but they let you run the same train quite a bit faster. So I got the tire off. Spare tire holder. I have a plate back here. Bolt sticking through. Lug nuts on the other side. Square tubing. A hitch. So I know my recovery point is solid and I'm not gonna tear it apart. That's pretty much all there is to my spare tire holder. Oh, one of the biggest complaints on a Viking is noise. I used a spray-on undercoating on the bottom of the bed. One, because, you know, a little bit of rubber on the bottom of the bed will help with vibration and noise, and for rust proofing, you know, it's sitting right above the wheel. I also have foam behind the seats in the back seat here. Goes under the seat. It's 3/8 to a 1/2 inch thick. Got my compartments under here. Got flaps cut out. And it hangs down here. So I had to take the seats out, put all this in, cut around all the mounting spots. I don't recall where I got the material from. I'm pretty sure I got it from Amazon. I also put the same stuff around the front, around the box here, because there's a lot of heat that comes up underneath the middle seat. And if you clog that off with something, it helps quite a bit to make a cooler ride. Got my fire extinguisher mounted in the center. Typically don't have a center passenger, but it's clips in there. Got a pretty cheap plastic mount, but I've run over some pretty rough terrain and it's never moved. Made a gas can holder, piece of sheet metal bent using the screw holes in the bed rails, holds on nice and solid. And got the small truck toolbox, got recovery straps, first aid kits, tire inflators, tire tools, a little bit of everything hiding in here. Box works nice. I would assume as long as you don't submerge it underwater, everything will stay dry. I haven't had anything wet in it yet. I couldn't find a blinker kit that I liked, so I had to make my own. I purchased this separately. It's designed for golf carts or whatever. I put blinker indicators here. I put a blinker relay that makes that annoying sound so you remember to shut the blinker off afterwards, because there's no cancel in the steering. For the front, I put the 3/4 LEDs in. For the rear, I wired the tail lights to work with the blinkers. And there was a horn switch, so. And we can't forget about the horn. So I have just over 4,000 miles and 243 hours on it. Got a mount for a tablet. I have a stereo. Mount for an off-road radio. Those are the speakers that came off my motorcycle. And I have a couple of Polk audio speakers in the back. So, I'm pretty happy with the way the machine's set up now. It does quite a bit. You know, it goes over some pretty ugly terrain. Fun to ride. Has a nicer ride than it originally did. I did put in the JBS Hot Rod Extreme kit and slug the wet clutch. That gave the machine a little bit more, you know, low end power, a little bit of top end speed. It was not a huge difference, but with the little bit of power these machines have, you know, getting a couple more horsepower to the ground makes a big difference.